everyone. My name is Shuai Yuan. I'm a senior accounting major at St. John's University. Today, I'm going to discuss with you about electronic commerce, which is a new business pattern after the invention of the internet. Firstly, I'm going to introduce a little bit of background about electronic commerce. Electronic commerce is consisted by four big groups: the retailers, suppliers, and customers, and electronic commerce company. Electronic commerce break down the traditional trading functions by the electronic commerce company creating a stage for the establishing the connection between between these different three groups. And also, the electronic commerce established a new business pattern of B2C, C2C, and B2B, which is the business to customer, customer to customer, and business to business. By considering the customers, customers is playing a really important role in electronic commerce because there's a big amount of population contributing in the electronic commerce market. So next thing I'm going to talk about, and also it's the main thing in my research, is populations. In order to show obvious trends of the population growth, I just found the existed statistic survey start from 18,000 to 2080, which shows an obvious line that the population is growing in these almost 300 years. The next thing is the e-commerce market rank. Here is the statistic survey about the top 10 e-commerce markets by country, which disclosed the first is China, United States, and the United Kingdom, Japan, Germany, France, Canada, and South Korea, and Russia. So here I address my research question. How is the population growth influence on the e-commerce market order? Why this topic is really important, and who is the intended audience? E-commerce market is playing, it's growing fast. E-commerce market is the only trillion industry that has the two digits growing rates every year. And also with the research done by the US Census Bureau, that only 7% of retail sales are done by internet in today's world. So which means that the e-commerce market has a big potential to growth. And also it affects many people, the investors, customers, retailers, suppliers. And also a lot of people could use this research, such as the Census Bureau, the researched country's government, and researched country's e-commerce company. Here's existing research talk about the market, the e-commerce market order in 8 different countries. The USA, China, the UK, Japan, Germany, France, South Korea, and Russia ranked in this order and predict to grow at different rates. Obviously, the growth is a common trend expected to be happened in the future, and also the really competitive countries, the USA and China, between these two countries, if it's only considering the business to customer business model, the United States it's going to be ranked the first. But if it's including the customer to customers, China will be the top in the e-commerce market. The research methodology, the first step I applied is analyzing the population each year from 2010 to 2016 in these 8 countries. But I switched the Russia to India because India has a big population in the world. It's the second biggest population country in the world. And estimate the future trend of the population up to 2025. And here it's what I firstly collect data from the stats website, which gives me a report of the population in these different 8 countries, and also it's in different years. I collect the data start from 2010 until 2016, and also I collect the report about the population growth rate, which gives me exactly the rate of each country's population growth rate, and then based on these data, I made an estimation by calculating the population use the previous year's population times the additional growing rate. So clearly we can see that India's population is going to beyond China in 2021. For the rest of the other countries, 5 of them are below in the 200 million, and only United States is the country, it's the third biggest country that has the population which is beyond 200 million. And second methodology is that I'm analyzing the online shoppers penetration over each country's population and estimate the future growth of the online shoppers population. I also find the data, the online shoppers population from the stats website, and also I based on the calculation of online shopper population, I got the online shopper population over total population by country, which gives me a rate of the online shoppers penetration. From the online shoppers penetration, we clearly can see that excluding China and India, all the other countries has almost reached 100%, which means almost everyone in these countries using electronic commerce in their life. But we clearly can see that China and India has a great potential to reach these countries because they have a lower penetration rate. So based on the penetration rate, I found the online shoppers population, we can clearly see that India and China has more population because of the total population growth rate and the big amount of the total population. And all the other countries is not changing a lot because of their population basis. The last methodology I applied is the online shoppers estimated population each year and calculate the total online shoppers spending based on the 2015 online shopper spending. I find the data about online shopper spending from a stats website, which gives me the average amount dollars of these 8 countries people spending in 2015. And I got the findings, I got the results for the total online shoppers spending. It is clear to see that China and United States, which has a big amount of occupation of the market. However, China will beyond the United States at the year of 2009 and 2020 without considering the economic growth, just only based on the population growth. And also, we can clearly see that India is the country with poor economic condition because it only has $150 per online shopper spending in 2015. However, by looking at the graph, we can see that India is going to beyond Japan, Germany, France, United Kingdom, and South Korea just only because of the population, the big amount of their population. So if I have more time, I would like to work on the economic trends by analyzing GDP growth and GDP per capita to get an idea about the economic growth, which is another big factor influence on the total market. And the limitation of my research is the future data is unknown. It's just based on an estimated rate. And also estimation is not what the real business will follow. What's your questions, and I will answer it. Thank you.